Hi guys, welcome to another episode of the EG6, the Motor Spirit EG6 series. What's been going on? Well, like I said in the last episode, I got myself to Cadwell Park for a bit of a test, track day. So a few things have happened with the Honda recently. Got my Motor Spirit stencils on, so we're official now. But as I said in the last episode, I've bought this MSD ignition coil relocator kit. So we've got the new top cap and rotor arm and the kit itself. So obviously I showed you last time where it goes. It's obviously part of the distributor kit, and all it does is relocate the ignition coil on the outside of the engine with an upgraded coil, because the ignition coil in here is known to be a weak part in the ignition system on Hondas. So I'm gonna crack on with that. Hopefully shouldn't take too long, a little bit of wiring, hopefully a nice fairly simple bolt-on job. I'll need to make a bracket for the ignition coil, not too sure where that's gonna go yet, but we can work that out as we go along. So I'm gonna unpackage this stuff, see what we've got, check out the instructions, see what I need to do and get cracking with that. Right then, see what we got in here, eh? Pro cap! So we've got the pro cap, that's the ignition coil, that's going to give us a nice big solid charge of electricity. Obviously the rotor arm, pretty standard looking. The only difference is so with this will feed from here to here and then feed the rotor arm off of the obviously the bigger coil. So let's have a look at this. I'm going to read the instructions, come up with a plan of action, and I'll get back to it. All right, that's the instructions read. Seems pretty simple, very simple in fact. So I'm going to pull out the old coil, find the wiring for that. It says to use the wiring from the coil inside the distributor, and that's blatantly going to spill, and drill a hole in the side of this and put the wires outside. But surely I'm thinking one of these wires, or two of these wires, are the two wires that go to, excuse me, to the rotor inside. So I can just come straight off the back of here and use the standard plug instead of having to do that. But we'll see how it goes. So first off, I'm going to mark up the leads, because I do not want that. Look, episodes ago when I had the leads on the wrong way round and it was all going tits. I don't know why I've walked over here. So mark them up, that's what I was going to do, but I'll mark them on the new cap, and then we'll get the coil out. Right, if you can see that. All right, let's make sure I get this right. So number one down there, one, two, three, obviously four. Right, that's that mark, so I'm going to get the cap off. Already, well, I don't know how old this is, but you can see there's quite a bit of corrosion in there. Always worth checking these sort of things momentarily. What's the word I'm looking for? Don't know, forgotten. The engine's facing the wrong way. Let's crank the engine over a bit.
Is it?
So I see why they said to extend these wires, because they don't just come straight from there, they go through the, is it the PCM or, excuse me, I can't remember what that's called, but they obviously go through that. I think they get a main power from the outside, but there's quite a few bits inside here that, yeah. So you can see that I'll have to extend these. Yeah, a bit of a bugger really, but should be able to make it, try and make it fairly neat so it doesn't look shit. So with that out, then we need to work out where I'm going to put this coil. I'm thinking on the side and the back here. Might be able to run these wires down. Underneath it, which we will, so we can run them down there and then mount that on there, maybe using this bracketry here, not only that, but I don't really want to get in the way of the timing screws. I'll have to have a think about that. And then we can start making the bracket up, and from there we'll get it all wired up and give it a test run. Okay, what I think I'm going to have to do is, I've had a look online and googled some pictures of what other people are doing. A lot of people mount it either here or have it back here with the big red wire running across. No, we're not doing that. There's one guy in the UK who's got the right idea. He's basically come off of these timing bolts, which I didn't really want to do, but it's not the worst case scenario. And then we can make a plate and just mount it there like that, and then we've got a nice short red wire to the coil, wrong to the cap. And that's it really. The only thing I need to do is run this wire in somewhere, but I can certainly make a little thing off of this bracket that I'll make for that to connect to, and that'll be it really. So I'm going to find a sturdy piece of steel plate and get that built. I love the way you look at me, I feel the pain you place inside. You lock me up inside your dirty cage while I'm alone inside my mind. I'd like to teach you all the rules, I get to see them set in stone. I like it when you chain me to the bed, but then your secrets never show. Your voice out of my head, 'cause I'm the guy you'll never find. I think you know all of the rules, there's no expressions on your face. I hope that someday you will let me go. Release me from my dirty cage. I need to feel you. You need to feel. These are good little things you can make for yourself. Just get a bolt, lop off the head, put this into your drill, and then against the angle grinder just turn it into a spike. And what I'll do is I'll feed that into the hole, into the threaded hole, and then where I want to make the hole on this metal plate, I'll just tap it lightly with a hammer, and that'll puncture a little dimple in the back of the plate and tell me exactly where I want my hole to be. Good little thing, easy to make,
yeah, good to keep hold of really. So I'm going to throw that in there now. Alright, morning. It's another day in the Motor Spirit headquarters. I've been doing stuff since the battery died, clearly. So the Dizzy is on, all wired up. I've got the wires laid out, good to go on the coil, and the coil is good to go. It's just the bracket. So I made my bracket. I painted it last night, and I'm letting it dry overnight. Excuse me. That will, no, I said a bit of a run, never mind, down the bottom. That'll do. Knuckles, that'll be in another episode where I get to fit my new wheel bearings. That's going to be a right treat. So, I'll put this bracket on. Fit the coil, obviously. I've made the short HT lead that runs from the coil to the top of the Dizzy there. There it is. The kit, the MSD kit, comes with a little crimping tool so you can make your own HT lead. Surprised actually, I didn't realise there was such a small amount of metal inside. I thought it'd be like a battery cable. No idea, but it's obviously really well insulated. And there's just a sort of thin cable that runs through the middle. But anyway, that's something I can look at later. So I'm going to fit this up and hopefully it's going to fire up. We'll see. Okay, that's it all fitted and wired up. I didn't bother filming it because you've seen me do it already. So I've got the wiring coming off the Dizzy, just need to put a bit of tape on there. The ignition lead made up. A little bit annoying that this is upside down, OCD's coming in, but yeah. However, moment of truth time, let's see if she'll freaking work. Oh God. Gonna make a clank because the drive shafts are free, but that'll do. Cool. Didn't want to run it because the drive shafts were just clunking around then. Not ideal. So now I've got to get that back together, but that's on another episode. So there you go, that is the MSD external coil kit fitted and running. Nice easy piece of kit to fit. I'm throwing what I'm thinking about. Yeah, the only thing I would say is if you're mounting it like I do, if you've done it off the timing bolts or that hold the distributor to control the timing, check your timing afterwards. So I'll be doing that. And yeah, that's it really. I'll let it warm up, check the timing, then I might give it a blast just to make sure it's all firing properly up the high end. But to be honest, if that's working, it should be working fine. So yeah, nice and easy. So I hope you enjoyed that. I hope that's helped some of you in some way. I'm going to crack on with the wheel bearings now, but I'll put that in a separate episode. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like and share if you want to keep following me and the progress of the car. And look forward to the next goal for me, which is racing at Rockingham September 10th and the track day tomorrow evening, which is Thursday evening. So I'll make sure I get some footage of that because I didn't get any at Cadwell and the car was flying at Cadwell. Right, I'll catch you later. Cheers. Bye. I love the way you look at me. I love the way you smack my